Hey guys, make sure to check out Flyaway Simulation. It's got loads of great stuff, including freeware downloads for FSX, the latest aviation news, forums, and a whole lot more. That's flyawaysimulation.com, or just search Flyaway Simulation. Hello, and welcome back to Jack's FSX Videos. Today for this tutorial, I'm going to be showing you the basics and some more advanced ways of how to set up your aircraft to take off. So basically how to take off. Although I'm using the Boeing 737-800, the principles are the same for almost every aircraft. So here's how to take off. Right, so the first thing you need to do is just jump inside the cockpit by pressing F9, and you need to set your flaps. Usually this is obviously, most of all this stuff is done over on the taxiway at the gate, but obviously I'm just here at the runway. So you can see a flaps lever down there. You can either just pull that forward with your mouse and drag it forward. You can use your joystick to do it, or you can just use the key commands by pressing F7 on this aircraft 4 times for 10 degrees. That's usually about what you do for this aircraft. I only put it at 5 at this point, but I do later put it at 10. So that's all you need to do for this point. And basically, you may be wondering right now why you need to even put flaps out at all, especially if you're new to aviation or FSX. You can just see them there coming down. It's basically just because it creates lift for the aircraft. It just makes it easier for it to take off. So about 10 degrees is normal for this aircraft under normal weather conditions. So the next thing you need to do is turn on your lighting. Again, this is something that is usually going at the gate. So the quickest way to do it is just to press L, which turns on all of your lights, as you can just see there, and then to go and manually turn off your taxi lights, because that is literally the only light that you do not need for takeoff. You need everything else, your landing lights, your strobe, wing, beacon, everything like that. One thing that you may also see that you might need to turn off is the runway turn off lights. On this aircraft they don't work at all, but if they do on some aircraft, make sure you turn those off as well. They're only used for landing. So while you're up here on the overhead panel, which can be accessed pressing Shift 5, you need to turn on your no smoking sign and fasten seatbelt signs. So you will hear a noise in the background there as you do it. Again, these are something that needs to be turned on over at the gate before even the passengers get on board, in theory. But the fasten seatbelt sign shouldn't be turned on while you're refueling. So at this point, you're pretty much set to take off. You can then push forward on the throttle, like I'll explain in a second, and take off. But if you're looking for slightly more advanced, just a couple more things, then you can keep watching. Otherwise, if you think that's good enough to set you off for now, then just skip ahead and watch the rest of the episode. So here's just a couple more small things for more of an advanced takeoff. Right, so for these couple more advanced tips on how to take off, one of those is setting up the autopilot, which I'll be releasing a video in a couple of days. All of the links will be in the description for these updated tutorials showing you fully how to do that. So the first thing is just to flick up the flight director switch, arm the auto throttle, then you set up your speed. For takeoff, it should be at around about 300, depending on obviously your aircraft, but for this one, around about 300. You don't need to set any of the buttons yet. Heading, usually runway heading when you're taking off, and then you set up your altitude to your first level. Usually ATC will tell you that one, along with the heading, if there is one. And then your vertical speed selector. Usually it's about 2500 for takeoff, and then once they're in the air a bit and gotten higher, you can bring that down to 22 or 20. The default 18 isn't usually what pilots go at unless there's been some sort of change mid-flight. And the other thing that you can do is set the auto brake. Now the 1, 2, 3 and max settings are only ever used for landing, so you don't need to worry about those for this episode. And then it's all automatically by default on the off. But what we're going to be looking at is the RTO switch. You may need to go into the 2D panel to use this, because often it doesn't work here, as you can see. So going to the 2D panel, and you can then switch it to RTO, which basically means if the pilot needs to abort takeoff, he can do so by reducing the throttle to idle, and then the plane will automatically start braking at maximum. So that's what that's there for. So you can just switch that to RTO. So once you've done all of that, that is all you need to do basically for the takeoff. There are a few other things, but this is just basically the basics. So once you've done that, you just hit the engines forward to 50% or by pressing the F3 key. You'll see the engine spool up there on the engine display on the bottom right. And once you see them do that, you can then slowly start pushing the throttle forward to 100% or by pressing F4. You do want to do it slowly, don't just kick it forward, take your time with it. And as you can see there, then the plane will obviously start moving along. And then you watch your speed on the bottom left of the display there, where it says 130, 135, 140, and then you can start to pull back on the stick, or obviously use your mouse and keyboard or whatever you're using, and then you're in the air, and then you can press G once you've got a positive rate, once you know you're flying upwards, and the gears will come in just like that. Right, so once you're in the air, sorry about my yoke, but once you're in the air and you're getting a good enough speed and everything, you know everything looks okay, you can then turn on the autopilot and also retract your flaps back to zero, because otherwise once you're in the air, they're just going to slow you down. They're only for taking off so that it creates lift. So you can retract those to zero. You can also just do your turn or whatever around about now once you're out from the airport, or once ATC has told you to, obviously depending on what you're using. So I'm just activating the autopilot here, so you just do the speed, the altitude, and the main autopilot, and if you've got a flight course put into the GPS, then you can just hit that switch there, nav hold, as long as the nav GPS switch is switched to GPS, and then the plane will turn accordingly. So that is it. So that's all you need to know for the basic takeoff. So you've got your flaps, lighting, and if you wanted the more advanced version, you've also got the autopilot in there and the auto brake. Okay, so thanks for watching this tutorial on the basics of how to take off in the Boeing 737-800, but like I said, it works with pretty much all aircraft, especially commercial jets. So that's it for this video. I'll be having more tutorials out in the near future. Thank you for watching.